Right, so I figured that we would take a look at some CDR stuff as an extra. I dug out some stuff. Here are some stuff that I used to have as a CDR. What is that doing over there? Still, I've saved all these things, you know. These are from various games. What is that doing over here? Still have all my CDR somewhere. Ah, finally some of these things. No idea what this thing is. It looks platinum toka. Two back cover, but front one is from black label. Charming inconsistency. Interesting. And found some games I have as a CDR. Pal, Lucky Luke. An interesting game. Pal, Spyro the Dragon. Too bad there's no Scandinavian copies on sale anywhere. And even if there would be, they would probably charge it for like 70 euros or something. NHL 99. PAL game. Toka 2. Disc broken. But not on the data. Hugo. Danish and Finnish edition. Colin McRae Rally 2. This disc doesn't want to go to the initial, go past the initial loading. Does not work. Rayman 2. If I recall, it was the NTSC. Here's a Hugo Black Diamond Fever, as it is known in English. I lended the game from a friend and took a copy. Sorry about that. And Paradox Intro Collection, which is a hassle to boot on an actual PS1, but hey, what can you do? Here's a Championship Motocross featuring Ricky Carmichael as this kind of CDR. And then I have a bunch of games that I have, but I still have the CDR. This is a Driver 2. Disc 1 out of 2. The Paradox Crack 1. Bad condition. Don't know if you can see it, but I had Disc 2, but again, thanks to someone from a family, I don't have that anymore. But I have the legit disc now, so it doesn't matter that much. F198. Same version I have nowadays. Gran Turismo 1. This one is interesting, you can see over here and over there. I think that's called bronzing. The disc has damaged, probably due to it, but it's partly on the data part of the disc. Then Gran Turismo 2 Arcade and Gran Turismo mode. Tomorrow Never Dies. The NTSCU version. I got PAL version, NTSCJ, and then quite recently a legit NTSCU version. So Vanishing Point, also NTSCU, something I got as a PAL version somewhat recently. V-Rally 2. I like Rayman 2, this is a Paradox crack. I have a legit disc now. Something I got from a friend, Driver 1. I think this disc has issues. Here's a story. I lended Crash 2 from this guy who gave it to me, and I took a copy of it. Wow, scratched even though not used. And I took a copy, but then he said, you can just keep that one, so there's that. And Crash Bandicoot 3, a PAL game. I had this one as a kid, then it broke, and I lended it from a friend, and I took this from it. But then I got my own platinum version, and you know, this became useless, and then I sold that platinum after getting a Black Label Scandinavian. Then we have Driver 2 again. I took these two when I lended a CDR from a friend. Took my own copies. So I had the chance to play the game through again, but not to listen to cutscene audio. My Trax data discs had the audio. That's a copy from a copy, so that might have something to do with it. And finally, The World Is Not Enough. Something I also lended from a friend as a CDR. And took a copy. Again, lost all the cutscene audio. Nice. But later I got a legit copy. Out of all those games over there, I would like to get Hugo and Spyro 1 as a legit disc someday. But we don't know if that ever happens. Yeah, those are all of the all of the CDRs I got left. Some are taken later, of course. Some are dying, some don't work, some still work perfectly. And I have a bunch of bootlegs I got from a friend who sold me the American PS1 It came with all those bunch of bootlegs. Dog is making noise. God damn it. But yeah, that's our look at some interesting stuff. I'm signing off and going to find out what's going on. Goodbye, sir.